Hey there, Capricorn. Welcome to your reading for the week of August 1st. Thank you for being here. Sorry, I just need to make sure that this microphone is good, but I think it's okay. So we're just going to get started here. And sorry, you know, I will take this card. It does say, it crazy enough, it says flexibility on it. I'm just doing like a regular old Celtic cross this week, and I can't figure out how to work my camera, so that's that. But we're just going to do a Celtic cross. Like I said, we will take that flexibility card. I'm laughing because literally I've said to all three earth signs, and I just said to Taurus that I was going to tell you too, that it's super important that you in particular, you earth signs, are super flexible at this time. Just because we have a collection of planets on the first, and you know, Uranus and Mars, and then the North Node, all at 18 degrees in Taurus. And so, you know, really what I would say is, number one, 18 degrees, you know, as I've said to everybody else, is like the degree of the devil. It doesn't mean something bad is going to happen. I just think that the warning here is right here, your crossing energy, this Knight of Wands. We'll talk about that in just a second. But you start off here with the Seven of Swords. I mean, literally, I could have just done probably one collective reading for the earth signs this week because I knew it was going to be all the same, and it pretty much is. Yours is actually different. You have some different stuff here, but for the most part, Seven of Swords is kind of a card of lying, cheating, stealing. Again, with all that stuff at 18 degrees, I would definitely be careful of anyone, like, you know, especially if you've dealt with someone in the past who was tricky or who's known to be a liar or who is known to not tell the truth, whatever you want to call it. I would definitely be careful of anyone like that at this time, especially with the Seven of Swords coming up. But what I would also say is that the Seven of Swords is about doing things differently as well, which I've said to all three earth signs. He is stealing these swords from this army that you can see in the very background there. So he's going to war, but he's doing it in a different way. He's not challenging the army head on. He is stealing the swords. So that is the energy in a nutshell that we're dealing with this week. And here you go. You have this flexibility card. Again, I think the most important thing that we can do this week in particular because of that energy is to be flexible, to do things, to just, you know, be open and spontaneous. Literally, your crossing energy, the Knight of Wands. The thing about the crossing energy is that crossing energy can be what hurts you or helps you. So this could be something that is actually helping you at this time, this crossing energy, but it could also be something that hurts you. So again, I always say tarot is not a prison sentence. This is something you can work with. And it's funny that I said to Virgo, you know, the first reading I did, that everybody's been getting the Knight of Wands this week. And the reason is because I feel like the energy is encouraging us to be flexible. And that's the easiest way to work around the energy. Again, this isn't going to be, it's not like going to be a bad week. I actually think it's going to be a good week, especially for the people that are flexible, that are spontaneous, that, you know, kind of know how to roll with the punches, so to speak. And I don't even think there are necessarily going to be any punches. I think if we see anything happening, it will be on a global scale, you know, as I've been talking about for months now. And, you know, I realize that, you know, some people say, stop getting political, which I have no political feelings at all, number one. Number two, it's like, you know, I'm not going to ignore it. You know, it's like I'm not going to put a blindfold on, right, and say that it's not going to happen when I've already proven, you know, I've already been proven right a couple of times here about exactly what was going to happen, right? So, you know, I would just keep your head on straight, like I said. And I don't think, you know, none of this is, you know, bad stuff either. You know, none of these things, it's like there might be some things that come out in the future, probably not even this year, that seem bad, but really is probably leading to something better. I would say that in your personal life, if something that seems bad happens in your personal life, it's probably, you know, for the better is what I would say. So kind of like spiritual flat tire type of energy is what I'm getting for you here. In the area of your thoughts, you have the Wheel of Fortune. I definitely like this for you in the area of your thoughts because I feel like you are very, very focused on turning things around, right? The Wheel of Fortune in your thoughts says that you have a personal vision for your life. The Wheel of Fortune is the card of your personal vision for your life, basically your destiny. But as I always say, to me, it's more a card of how you see your destiny. And you know, what really is your destiny? Who knows, right? But what I would say here, it's like kind of how you see it. And I feel like this is a good thing for you. It's like whenever the Wheel of Fortune comes up, I always say that the person I'm reading for is probably in control of their destiny, unless there's something that's showing up that could say that you're not. But I would say in your case, I feel like you are very much in control of your destiny, or at least your vision, how you see your kind of personal vision for your life going. You do have the Queen of Cups here. Oh, sorry, wrong camera. You have the Queen of Cups here. You also have the King of Cups over here as well. So this is showing up in your foundation, the Queen of Cups. For the past few weeks, pretty much everyone has had the King and Queen of Cups showing up in their readings. It could be love. And actually for you, I do feel like there could be love because your outcome is that Page of Cups, which we'll talk about in a minute. But I feel that this is more talking about that your foundation is your emotions. Again, for the past few weeks, pretty much everyone has been getting the Queen and King or one or the other in their reading. We had that Cancer moon a couple weeks ago, and you are the opposite sign of Cancer, of course. So that moon definitely had an effect on you and your life. And, you know, really, I feel like it's more about like tapping into your feelings and how you feel about things, but also paying attention to your feelings, being like, how do I feel about, you know, X, Y, and Z? And really kind of like trusting your feelings. She is looking at that cup, and I always say that cup almost looks like a trophy, and it represents the fact that she really, really values how she feels about things. She really, really cares. Sorry, I just got something in my eye. She really cares about how she feels about things in general, so trust your feelings. In the area of the past, you have the Two of Wands. You know, I kind of like this showing up in the past because the story of the Two of Wands is that this guy thinks that he has experienced everything that there is to experience, but there's like actually a lot more for him to experience. So as an energy that you are moving past, I feel like you are experiencing things on a whole other level. It kind of says or suggests that you are grabbing on to this world that he's holding on to right here. So in a lot of ways, I feel like you are kind of opening up to new opportunity. Next, you do have the Five of Cups in your near future. Five of Cups is regrets and disappointments, but I always say that the Two of Cups is about turning around, seeing these two cups, because you don't just get the two cups, you get the bridge and the castle over here as well. So again, I'm not going to sugarcoat the energy, I'm not going to sugarcoat the reading. You know, based off the astrology, I would definitely say this is exactly, you know, what basically everybody could be dealing with is some sort of disappointment. But the trick is, number one, to be flexible. Number two, the trick is to be grateful for what we do have. And if we can do that, then we're going to find something much, much better than we thought we were going to have in the first place, you know? And I know that sounds confusing, but it's like if you thought you were in your dream relationship and it's come to an end recently, you're probably about to find something much better. If you have a business failure or a career failure or anything like that, you're probably on the edge of finding something much better. Again, the trick with this Uranus, North Node, Mars energy, I personally believe, is that Knight of Wands. I literally said it in the Virgo reading. I've been saying this for like the past month because the Knight of Wands has been coming up like crazy in readings. We need to be super flexible and spontaneous. I feel like embracing that Knight of Wands energy is exactly what the astrology, the universe, whatever you want to call it, wants us to do. It wants us to tap into that like spontaneous side of things, you know, where we have a goal. We have things that we want to accomplish, but maybe how we get there doesn't matter so much. He's ready for the adventure. You know, Knight of Wands, he's like on the positive side of things. He's that friend that where you could say, hey, let's drive cross country, and he's there. He doesn't need to know the details, doesn't need to know like when you're stopping for snacks, how many times you're going to take a break, if you're going to drive straight through the night or what you're going to do. He's just down to clown. You know, he is down for the ride. And I feel if you can embrace that energy, this won't even matter. Plain and simple. Next, in the area of your next few months, here you go. You have the Judgment card. Love it. Amazing. Definitely feeling like you are answering your calling. I feel like you feel like you have more of a purpose as well. Literally, that's the words that are popping into my head is purpose. Like, I feel like you feel like you have a purpose. Like, you're doing something that matters in your life. Like, you feel like you're on the right path. And I really just am seeing this in your reading as confirmation. So, I feel like you're definitely going in the right direction. And you're definitely going to be experiencing changes, but good stuff. Next, in the area of your closest relationships, you have the King of Cups. The King of Cups is about love, so there could be love coming in for you at this time with the King of Cups. The King of Cups is also, again, about your emotions. This is in the area of your closest relationships. So you could be just, receiving a lot of positive energy from your closest relationships. You could also be finding that you're like maybe more emotionally connected to the people around you, like all people, your family, your friends, people that you care about and love. And you could just be, wanting to spend time with them. I would definitely do that if you feel that energy. I would be, doing everything you can to soak up as much positive energy as you can at this time, Capricorn. So, if you're feeling super connected to people, go spend time with them, especially if you are spending time with them. Really enjoy yourself. Have a good time. It's just going to help you with this King of Cups energy. I do also feel like there could be a water sign or a fire sign coming in for some of you. You can have both here, and so it could be one or the other. Could be any sign. It's a general reading. Take it how it resonates. You have the King of Wands here. The King of Wands is about being bold, being assertive, really going for what you want. This is showing up in the area of your future feelings. So I feel like you are feeling bold, assertive, ready to go, ready to take action, ready to make things happen here. And I definitely really like that for you as well. Finally, you have the Page of Cups as your outcome. The Page of Cups could definitely be an admirer or love coming in for you, but he has this fish in that cup right there that you can see, and that fish represents your imagination. It represents something that you could be imagining happening. It could be something that you want to have happen in your life. I always say with the Page of Cups that that fish, to me personally, represents something you have to kind of grab onto, that you have to sink your claws into here. You don't have any claws, I'm sure of it, Capricorn, but I would say, if you did, sink your claws into it, because there's definitely a lot of stuff kind of about your destiny, your personal vision for your life, Wheel of Fortune, judgment, right? So you're clearly going in the right path, even if you maybe this week happen to feel like you're not. With the Seven of Swords and the Knight of Wands, you have the Eight of Wands. Yeah, quickest way to success is going to be both of those energies, actually. Again, the crossing energy in a Celtic cross is not necessarily bad energy. It could be what's, in a Celtic cross, it's what's hurting you or helping you or both. And I would say being spontaneous, like I said, being just, down to clown, that is like the perfect, words for this energy. And I also say that because he has these, there you go, cards are flying. He has these polka dots on his cloak. And the polka dots represent needing to have more fun, needing to enjoy yourself, needing to do things that you love to do. The polka dots in the tarot, they kind of represent needing to have fun. So, basically down the clown here is what I would say to you. With the Wheel of Fortune, you have the World. Are you kidding me? So an achievement, focusing on something. I was talking about the World and that Two of Wands. And the World card to me, we start in the tarot as the Fool, and we make it all the way to the World if you follow the Fool's journey, and then you're reborn into a new world and you start as a Fool again, right? We just are always going through this cycle. So I feel like you're ready for a new cycle. I feel like you're ready to kind of step into a much better energy in your life. With the Queen of Wands, you have the Page of Wands. Page of Wands is about going on an adventure, going on a journey. So I feel for a lot of you that you are going on some sort of adventure or journey at this time. And Queen of Cups would say follow your heart as well, which I've said to several signs in the August readings. I've said it to several signs this week as well. I think that maybe our heart is kind of telling us we want something right now. Whatever it is, it could be like some sort of fulfillment. It could be to go watch a movie. It could be anything. Sometimes I think the problem with these heart-based things is that we judge them, right? It's like if your heart is telling you go watch the new Jurassic Park movie, it's like you might be thinking everybody said that movie sucked, right? But it's like, I don't know, maybe you just like dinosaur movies. So just like go watch it. And, this is like one of those times where, people might think I'm crazy, but, I think there could be kind of like crazy things that happen right now where it's like maybe your heart tells you to go watch Jurassic Park movie, you go watch it, and, maybe there's some sort of answer in the movie to a problem you've been dealing with. Maybe the characters say something that gives you like an epiphany, right? And it's like with Neptune and Pisces as well, if there was ever a time where we could get random ass answers from random ass situations, events, experiences, it would be right now. So I keep telling people, your heart tells you to do something, as long as it's positive, not going to hurt anyone else or you, do it, because it probably has an answer. With the Five of Cups, you have the Lovers. I feel there could be new love for some of you. For those of you who are interested in love, I do feel like this could be love. I do feel like it's new love, and I do feel, I kind of get this weird thing about needing to let go of someone from the past here, Capricorn. It's like, I don't even know how to describe this, honestly. Intuitively, what I feel is this is like some sort of situationship. So, you know, take it how it resonates. This might only be for a couple of you. But if this is for you, I feel like there could be a situation where you're still talking to a person. It's like, I literally feel like the second you let that person go, it's like there's going to be someone else. and for others, it's like I do get this energy of someone who just isn't willing to let your energy go, you know? It reminds me of people always ask me, you know, people used to ask me all the time like about being friends with their exes. And I always tell people, you know, I think it's really hard to be a friend with your ex because it's like once you have some sort of interaction with that person, you know, adult friendly time, adult fun time, right? Let's put it that way. It's like, it's kind of hard to see that person as a friend, number one. And I'm not saying we have to be mean to our exes or anything like that, but it's like we create an energetic bond with that person. And once you do that, it's like it's there, you know, it's like there forever. And sometimes I think, you know, I don't think it's always true, but definitely I feel if we're honest with ourselves and we say, hey, by me still interacting with this person, they're basically preventing me from moving on. And I kind of, and again, take it how it resonates, but I do feel that for some of you, where if you're still interacting with a person, talking to them, whatever, you know, that could be the thing that is preventing you from meeting someone new. With the Judgment card, you have the Queen of Swords. I feel like you see things clearly over the next few months. I feel like this is going to be a really good part of the year for you. There are some signs where I really feel the second half of this year is awesome, and you are one of them. Even though we have Jupiter going retrograde, Jupiter, it doesn't matter if Jupiter is going forward or backwards. It really doesn't matter. Jupiter is always positive. Yes, we have Mars going retrograde as well, Saturn right now as well, and all this other stuff. But, you know, to me, it doesn't matter. I feel for you that there could be a great deal of clarity. That's the thing I think people forget about retrogrades. It's like, yeah, retrogrades can bring confusion, but they can also bring things back from the past in a good way. They can bring back clarity from something that you dealt with a long time ago. Maybe you've been working on the same project for many years, and these retrograde times can bring in clarity on what you've already been working on. So, you know, I think people need to, number one, realize that astrology, tarot, you know, again, I do this for a living. I've been reminding people lately that has very little control over your life, if any at all, right? You control your own life, period, plain and simple. But, you know, I do feel that these retrogrades are going to be kind of like positive for you in some ways, probably bringing back, you know, clarity about things that you've dealt with. With the King of Cups, you have the Tower. It did come up in reverse here. You know, I actually prefer the Tower upright because the Tower upright, it's like, yeah, sometimes Tower moments suck, but they also are necessary. They are also, you know, they bring us back to reality. They make us see things for how they actually are. And that's the whole point of the Tower. These people are being brought back down to reality. What I will say is sometimes in reverse, it can say that you kind of get ahead of the Tower moment, if that makes sense, where it's like you actually do come back down to reality without needing the Tower moment. So I feel that for some of you. Again, for others, you know, this could be, I wouldn't really call it a breakup, but, you know, I do feel for some of you could be like walking away from a person because you know that they're taking up, you know, too much of your energy. They're not willing to, you know, get this going anywhere. With the King of Wands, you have the Four of Pentacles. I really feel you need to embrace that King of Wands energy. Again, I feel like everybody does, but, you know, being bold, being assertive, really going for things. He's extremely nurturing as well. I think that's something people forget about him. You have the King of Cups as well, also extremely nurturing, and the Queen of Cups, but the King of Wands, he's like a little bit different. He's like the entrepreneur of the tarot. He treats, you know, he pretty much raises anything that he works on as a baby. It might not literally be a baby, it might be his business or something like that, but he really, really nurtures things. He gives it his all. Four of Pentacles, you know, can be a card of holding on too tightly to something, but actually for you, I feel like it's pretty good. I feel like you're just, I'm getting more kind of like commitment vibes, like you're committed to being more bold, assertive, and really going for what you want. With that Page of Cups, you have the Page of Pentacles. There you go. Definitely could be communication coming in for you. So if you're looking for new love, I feel like that could be a new love partner coming in for you there, for sure. Could be a fire sign. You have basically everything here: water, earth, fire, pretty much everything, air. So it could be any sign, but this is a pretty straightforward reading. Like I said, it fits in very well with the astrology. So thank you for being here, Capricorn. Really appreciate it. Make sure to watch your sun, moon, and rising for a full picture of what's going on for you at this time. But thank you, and definitely enjoy your week.